y'all, it's Sheridan LeBay here with another installment of Marketing Mondays. Super excited to be back. Like I told you guys in the last video, definitely working at providing more consistent content. So this is me doing that. I'm going to be coming to you guys with a variety of topics, probably not just solely on marketing, but just about business, entrepreneurship, and if I get questions about things to answer, I definitely will start talking about those as well. So for those that don't know me, I own Untamed Marketing. I am a marketing consultant. I'm an event planner and also own a lingerie boutique, and I do everything under the sun. So I'm probably a Jill of all trades to some people, but that's fine. I don't really care. So today I want to talk about things that I've learned over the last 4 or 5 years doing business. I'm going to talk about some things from the business side, from the event side, marketing, working with people, clients, just a general like, hey, here's what I did, here's what I've learned. Don't make the same mistakes that I made necessarily. So super excited. I'm going to run down a list, going to get into some few high points and kind of go into some details, and we'll go from there. So one of the first things I would say when you're launching a business is everything's not going to be perfect. Like, it's just not. And I know that's hard. A lot of us are perfectionists, but it's just not. Everything's not going to be perfect. And what I've learned from my own business and from also like some of my mentors that I have is you just have to launch it. Of course, you want to do things the right way. You want to do things the legal way, but you also have to acknowledge that everything's not going to be perfect when you launch, but you just got to launch it, and you can perfect it as you go. One of my mentors, he tells me that all the time, and I'm like, okay, like, that's fine, cool, I guess I'm okay with it, right? So that would be my first tip. Like, if you have a business idea, go for it. Like, do it. Don't worry about what other people are saying. Don't worry about if you know 10 other makeup artists or 10 other lingerie boutique owners. They're not you. At the end of the day, I think that's important because we live in a society where it seems like everybody's doing the same thing and they're really not. It's just it's not even hindsight. It's just the sphere of influence and people that we're around. You'll feel like everybody's doing something. That's not the case at all. And even if they were, they're not you. So whatever. So that would be my first tip. My second tip would be to price yourself accordingly and not be afraid to go up on your prices. And that's something I'm even 4 or 5 years in, like, I'm still learning to set reasonable prices and not be afraid to go up on those prices, not be afraid to, when you get a new client and you're desperate for clients, desperate because you haven't had a new client in months and you're trying to pay a bill or you want to go on a trip and you're just like, okay, I will set this certain price just because I just want to make sure I get a client. Don't do that. Like, please don't do that. Price yourself accordingly, because if you don't charge what you really truly want to charge, you're going to build resentment and you're probably not going to do as great a job as you would if you had charged what you wanted to charge. So that is my next tip, is know your worth, charge it. Don't be afraid to not work with a client because they don't want to pay. And you'd be surprised too. Something I've learned over the years is that the people that you would think would pay the high prices are more stingier with their money. And that's no shade to anybody, but I've noticed that people that you would think would have a more fluid budget, just for a variety of reasons, like just because of the type of business they're in, or because of what they're requiring, what they want, you just never know who's gonna pay. It's not always, I guess my point is, it's not always who you think it's gonna be. It's not always the big companies that are gonna pay the big bills. Sometimes it's the small mom and pop who are like, yeah, we'll throw $10K at this, and a big corporation's like, oh, we only have $500, you know? So don't be surprised, don't count out your, don't discredit a business because you think they don't have the budget. Because I promise you, the people that have the budget that will pay are not who you think it would be. So that would be my next tip. My third tip would be to take breaks. Give yourself grace and take breaks. I went through a period of entrepreneurship probably like 2 years ago where I was just like, I was my business. I breathe my business. My business is me. I am she. Like, I live, breathe, eat entrepreneurship. And if you want to have a life outside of your business, you're going to have to like time manage, and you're going to have to prioritize even your own wellness. Like, I wasn't doing that. Like, I mean, I was, but I wasn't. And then I, you know, dealing with relationships and friendships, and people can feel neglected. Those are things, those are valid concerns, and you want to feel like you're giving the people in your life like attention, right? So that would be my third tip, is take breaks, and also don't forget about your family, your friends, your partner while you're building your business, or while you're growing your business if you've already started. Tip number four would be, don't feel like you have to collaborate with everybody. I think that I know that I'm a super talented person. Like, I come up with great ideas all the time. And I think over the years, like, I've been scared to necessarily just launch something by myself. So I'm like, ooh, who can I collab with this on? Or who can I involve? And part of it is like, I'm very big on bringing other people along with me too. But it also can be detrimental feeling like you have to always like collab with somebody, you know? So that would be my next tip, is don't feel like you always have to collab with somebody. That's just not a thing. You don't have to do that. You're still gonna be a great business without it. My next tip would be build brick by brick. So what that means is, like, knowing what I know now, I would do things differently, but I would have, yes, I hit the ground running, but once I built a certain capital, I would have put more processes and like legality things in place years ago. So I started my first business in 2014. I was doing like essay editing, essay writing, resume editing, a little bit of social media, like random writing tasks. Like back in 2014, I was definitely more heavier on the writing side than then I kind of evolved into the design side, and now I'm more strategically managing people who do those things. Just a little flex or whatever. But no, so I lost my mind. But what I was saying is, in retrospect or in hindsight, I would have started doing certain things. Like, I had my logo. I guess for me, I would have just had things more organized very early on. So I would have had a basic website. I would have at least gotten my DBA early. I would have started a separate business bank account. And those are things I did, but I feel like I didn't do them fast enough, if that makes sense. Having a set and actually separating my business finances, that would be my additional tip, like an asterisk. When you get those things in place, separate your business expenses from your personal life. Pay yourself through your business. Don't commingle things just because you don't want to deal with the legality. My next tip would be, document everything. And not just in the sense of like emails, but just document the things that you're doing. Like, if you launch your business in the first year, you are doing selling bow ties, right? And say 5 years from now, you are a stockbroker, or you're teaching people like finance classes or something. I think that I documented a lot. I didn't document enough, but I would just document so you can go back and say, hey, I don't write anymore, but these are all of my blog posts, which I saved all of my blog posts, which I might just repurpose. Hey, this is an event I did 10 years ago. Like, just for your own well-being or your own benefit, like, document your stuff. Document the process that you're making, and document your processes. So that would be my next step, or next tip that I've learned, is documenting things. Like, anything that requires a process for your business, start documenting it, so that when you build a team, you already have all these things documented, versus hiring a team and then you're like, oh crap, I gotta go document everything that I've been doing for the last 4 years. So speaking of teams, my next advice would be, definitely build a team, but don't feel pressured to build a team, but you'll know when you need to build a team. Like, you'll know. I started off, and I got a social media assistant probably like after my first year in. I got a social media assistant. That was to handle my social media because I was doing so many other people's social media, but I was just like, I don't have time. So I couldn't give my own personal brand like the energy, right? Like I couldn't give my own brand like the energy. So that would be my next suggestion is, when you like, don't be afraid to build a team. Don't force building a team, but don't be afraid to ask for help. Like now, this is my second go around having a team, and we are hitting the ground running. And these ladies will probably be here for the long haul and be the future director of marketing for Untamed Lingerie. So definitely allocate it. Someone told me a long time ago, you can run your business and make $50,000, or you can pay somebody $10,000 to assist you and they help make you another $50,000. I'm saying $10,000, that's just an arbitrary term, arbitrary dollar, but I mean, if they're your assistant, $10,000 probably, $10,000 a year probably on par if you're paying them $1,000 a month to do a certain amount of hours a month. So that's not far-fetched, but the point is you can do more with more people. My next tip would be, don't listen to the naysayers. Like, everybody has an opinion about your business. Everybody has an opinion about how you should run your business, about every business idea. People may have an opinion because they think you do too many different businesses. Like, I'm a firm believer in, if you're not paying my bills, your opinion really doesn't matter. Like, it really doesn't. That's rude or whatever, but that's truly how I feel. And I had to learn that early on because I've experimented with different businesses. I've done multi-level marketing. I've done a lot of things in the last 6 years since I've graduated undergrad. And you'll get a lot of feedback and you'll get a lot of opinions. And it's like, what is that? Like, what does that have to do with me? Like, how does that benefit me at all? It doesn't. So that'll be my last tip. I wanted to make this a quick video. But yeah, I just feel like those are some quick things that I've learned over the years. I think if you have a business idea, you definitely should go for it. A lot of my friends, like I started very early because as early as I could make money, I've been working. So I've always had some type of income since I was like 15 or 16. Because I think you could work at Victoria's Secret at 15. No, I worked at another store. I was going to say the name, but then like, those be security questions, so I'm not going to say it. But I was working at the mall at 15. So I've always had money coming in outside of just like my parents. So I'm saying that to say that I've learned a lot. And I think you should just go for it. I think that life is too short to feel like you have to sit on your ideas. I have so many friends that have so many great ideas, and I'm like, so when are we going to do it? Like, I'm the friend that you can't tell me your idea because I'll call you the next day and be like, so I looked this up and all we need to do is woo 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 and blase blase blase, and it's a thing. They know that. So now people don't come to me unless they're like serious. But you have, like, we just have to stop playing small. I think that's a thing. I guess I'll talk about that too. I was gonna say that for another video, but I'll talk about that right now too. It's like, we live in a time, especially, I'm gonna talk speaking as a Black woman, we feel like we have to tone down who we are. We feel like we have to appease other people's egos. And I'm not referring to men, I'm referring to other women. I think we live in a generation or a time where we're afraid to share our wins. We're afraid to be the bosses that we are because we don't wanna make somebody else around us feel away. And it's like, other people's insecurities are not our problem, honestly. And I'm saying that as somebody who I've had to limit over the years, other people's insecurities are not our problem. Literally, it's not our problem. And we will waste so much life worrying about what our parents think, what our friends think, what our partners think. And it's like, at the end of the day, when we take our last breath, we have to be satisfied with who we are at the end of the day. And I don't know who's watching this. I feel like somebody's probably watching this and you've been sitting on a business idea or a hobby. Everything doesn't have to be monetized. But you're probably sitting on a hobby or a business idea and you're afraid of not getting support from your friends. You're afraid of trying to find the funding. You're afraid of, oh, I don't have enough time. And like I told one of my friends, I was talking to them about going back to school. And their apprehension is the fact that they're older than me. I was gonna say older, not old y'all, because I'm about to be that age. They're a few years older than me, so they're in their early 30s. And they're just like, I don't wanna go back to school. You know, it's gonna require so much time, and the time's gonna go by regardless. So if I'm sitting on a diet idea right now to be an ice cream man, and I'm like, I don't wanna do it because of whatever stupid reason my brain has convinced me, those 5 years, like 2025 is gonna be here regardless. So 2025 can be here and I could have fulfilled my dreams, or I could have sat here and said, hey, I don't wanna do it because it's gonna take too much time, when like time is gonna happen like regardless. I don't get that about people. That's kind of frustrating, honestly. I don't get that because it's like the time is gonna pass regardless. Like regardless, 5 years is gonna pass. You can either spend 5 years working on what you love and building something that you love, or you can sit here and be dormant and stagnant. So that is definitely something that I urge everyone. I was gonna make that a separate video, but I think that can be my last tip, is not playing small. I think for me, it's something I've struggled with, and I've gotten into the space this year where I'm just like, I'm here, okay? I'm here, I'm doing it. I'm not gonna lie about the businesses that I have. I'm not gonna lie about the wins that I'm taking. I'm not gonna lie about the success I've had. It's here. If it makes you feel uncomfortable, I'm sorry. Hopefully it inspires you versus making you feel uncomfortable, but you can't control how your life makes other people feel. And it's not your job. I guess that's my whole thing too. It's not your problem. Like, it's not your problem. Your business is making sure that you're happy with the person that you have to look in the mirror. Look in the mirror with every day. Does that make sense? Look in the mirror. Y'all know what I'm saying. Y'all know what I'm saying. But you really have to push past that. Like, you have to push past self-doubt. You have to push past wanting other people around you to feel comfortable, because you're going to attract your tribe of people and your supporters as you elevate. People are going to come. The business is going to come. The consumers are going to come. The partnerships, the clients, all of that is going to come. But you, it starts with you at the end of the day. It starts with you. It starts with the person in the mirror. It starts with us saying, I've had a dream of living in LA, and I'm gonna do that, and whatever happens around me because of that decision, I'm okay with it, because I made a decision to live the life that I wanna live. And I feel like that is, especially something in the South. If you're from the South, please comment and let me know if I'm off base with this, but I think a lot of people in the South, we move slower. Like, I meet people from New York and DC and California, and they're like, y'all move slow in Texas. I don't know what it is. Slavery didn't held us back. And no, I'm kidding. But in all seriousness, we move slower down here for whatever reason it is. And because of that, that also tied into that slowness is like, a lot of people in Texas, especially Houston, are afraid of moving out of the city. They're afraid of leaving what the norm is from their families. They're afraid of just, and I've been guilty of that. So I'm saying others, but I've also feeling guilty of that, because if I had my way, or if I had followed my first mind, I would have not been in Houston like 3 years ago. And I was trying to please other people, but regardless, it's gonna happen. So it's neither here nor there. But you have to, like, we have to get to a point where we are willing to take the risk, because life is short, in the sense of, I know everybody has their different comfort levels. And they're different, like, we get stuck in patterns, I guess you can say. And it's like, but for what? Like, okay, I spent the last 50 years of my life spending every Sunday with my family, going to the same 9-to-5, taking the same 2 vacations a year, wearing the same raggedy clothes to work, doing the same stuff day in, day out, day in, day out. For what? Like, what? Why does that even matter? Because when we die, like, it literally doesn't matter. So why not take the risk? Why not go on the trip? Why not start the business? Why not start some new friendships? Why not end some friendships? Why not start a relationship? Why not end a relationship? Why not cut your hair? Why not color your hair? Because these bodies are temporary. These bodies are temporary. I'm gonna say it again. These bodies are temporary. This life is temporary. So we could either spend the life living the same life day in and day out for 50 years, or we can challenge ourselves and push ourselves, because guess what? If you fail, you didn't die. If you went and moved to that city and you hated it, you can move back. If you started that business and it fails, start another one. You took a chance on a relationship and it ended, there's a million other people in the world for you today. I think that it's time for people to really start living. Because at the end of the day, Marley, get out. No, I was like, why is the door opening? She did. Be back, guys. I was like, wait, why is the door opening? Okay. Anyways, my friend's dog is hilarious and she just burst in here. I'm like, I know you're lying. But anyways, small interjection. But where was I at? I was talking about living your freaking life. No. But seriously, we really do. I think that we get caught up in the routine. We get caught up in the norm. We just get comfortable. And it's like, what does that benefit us? Because this life is so temporary. And we've seen that with 2020. And I've seen a lot of people, like, this year has really, like, brought out another side of them, you know? And I want to see more of that. I want all of us to push past security and go forth towards another lifestyle. I think there's another life waiting for us on the other side of comfortability. So hopefully you took something from these business tips / life tips. These are things that I've learned. I have no regrets about anything I've done in business, because it all makes sense now. It's one of those, like, you do things and it's like, man, I could have did this, but it wouldn't have brought me here. I'm just one of those people. I'm not very regretful about a lot of things. But I really do. I really hope that these tips helped you business-wise and in life. I think the last thing that we talked about not playing small, like, why? Why play small? Why? What are you gaining from playing small? Seriously. So, thank you so much for listening in. Just a little backstory for those first time watching. On the business side of things, I'm an event planner. I help with anything related to marketing or design. So, I help businesses with their strategic plans, with websites, flyers, copywriting, logos, creative direction for video sets, like, that's my thing. Anything marketing and design. I also host these really fun events called Untamed Nights. We haven't done them in a while because of the pandemic, but they're basically these, like, taboo events. I've, like, lost my train of thought. Marley distracted me. But these taboo events that just get people thinking outside of the box. And then, of course, I have my Untamed lingerie brand. So really just enjoy you taking the time out listening. Hopefully you were able to get something from this that was inspirational. I kind of re-inspired myself listening as well. So thank you again. Enjoy your day. Do something today that scares you, that you've been wanting to do for a long time. So until next time, I am Sheridan LeBay with House of Untamed, and I will talk to y'all later. Bye.